All right, here we are with Doug McKain from DodgersNation.com. Dodgers dugout, you can see it on YouTube, and obviously it's everything Dodgers. I mean, look at it. You're there, you got the headset on, you're ready to go. We got game one of the World Series, Doug. I got the Dodgers winning the thing in seven. It's going to be quite interesting.
Dodgers in seven? Yeah. Hey, anything for a parade, that would be very tense. That would be very high stakes. I'm sure the blood pressure would be high. But I think when you look at this matchup, this is the matchup that fans have dreamed about for a long, long time. Major League Baseball, fans across the world with Shohei Ohtani and Aaron Judge. And you have the two flagship franchises, the two blue bloods of the sport, facing off for the first time in the Fall Classic since 1981. It's New York versus L.A., Hollywood versus Broadway. And I think the big thing for me is it's not just the two greatest franchise in the sport. It's not just the fact that you have 22 World Series appearances for the Dodgers, 41 for the Yankees, 63 combined. That's the most all time. It's the fact that you have both of these teams with the two biggest stars on the planet facing off. You have Shohei Ohtani and Aaron Judge. It's the first time since 1976 that you've had two MVPs, Ohtani and Judge, and the teams with the best record in the National League and the American League facing off in the World Series. So it's going to be an exciting matchup. Baseball needs it. We need it. But most importantly, we need the Dodgers to beat the Yankees, and we need that parade in L.A.
Oh, you are dying for the parade. Okay, so I look at it like this, that you want a parade, you better get some good pitching from two guys, Yoshinobu and Jack Flaherty, because if that doesn't happen for Dodger fans, they're not winning because they're going to have to go to the bullpen for a couple times in a seven-game series. So they need Flaherty not to have that outing like he had in game five against the Mets where he was roughed up after three innings with eight runs, right? I mean, that's it. I mean, if he comes out in game one and does not deliver a quality outing, the Dodgers may be in trouble.
Absolutely. I mean, they announced today, Dave Roberts told us that Jack Flaherty is going to be the Dodgers game one starter. And it has been a little bit of a mixed bag for Flaherty this postseason. The Padres series didn't have a great start. And then game one of the NLCS against the Mets, he went seven scoreless. It was the longest outing for a Dodgers pitcher in the postseason since Max Scherzer in 21. And then he didn't have a good start in game five, went just three innings and gave up eight runs. That's tied for the most ever for a Dodgers pitcher in the postseason. So we've seen high ups and we've also seen some downs. But in that game five start against the Mets, he was under the weather. The fastball velocity was down. The spin on the breaking stuff wasn't right there. Didn't have the command. And as far as Yoshinobu Yamamoto, I mean, this is a $325 million pitcher. This is a guy that signed the most lucrative contract ever for a starting pitcher, and they signed him for series like this. And during the summer, he had his best start of his career when he had seven scoreless innings against this Yankees team. Yes, they were without Juan Soto at the time, but this is a pitcher that I've talked to a couple different times, and one thing that he always has mentioned to me is he loves the big stage. He loves the bright lights. That is what Yoshinobu Yamamoto is built for, but you're absolutely right. They need Flaherty, they need Yamamoto to give you quality starts, and you also need Walker Buehler, someone who's had this reputation for being a big-game pitcher, to look like the guy that we saw a couple years ago. And good thing for the Dodgers, he had his best start since 2021 in Game 3. So you got three starters that you need, and then that bullpen has been lights out. They call them the dogs in that bullpen, and you look at how dominant they've been and what they've been able to do for this team. They staved off Game 4. They staved off elimination in Game 4 against the Padres, and they also won the Game 6 clincher. So they have enough pitching to get it done, but you're absolutely right. You definitely need some length from those starters to be able to win this series.
Yeah, and so if you go deep diving into this series, obviously the two-storied franchises, but you got Judge, you got Ohtani, you could just break this. You could go position by position. Is there anything, one thing that you think is going to stick out for the team that actually wins this series that they need to do really well at?
Oh, 100%. For the Dodgers, if you follow this team for years, the biggest issue in the postseason has been their ability to hit with runners in scoring position. The regular season, you see them score tons of runs. They'll execute runners in scoring position. And then when the postseason comes around, you see the offense go ice cold. Well, it's been a different scenario this time around. The offense has hit 311 with runners in scoring position this postseason. That's the best in baseball. You compare that to the Yankees, they're hitting 181. So that's the big difference. And also, too, Yes, you're going to get contributions from Shohei Ohtani and Mookie Betts. And Freddie Freeman said today that he 100% expects to be ready to go for the World Series. But the difference between this team is you've gotten contributions down in the order. I mean, just look who won the NLCS MVP. It was Tommy Edman. Tommy Edman wins the NLCS MVP, and he tied Corey Seager for most RBIs in a championship series with 11. So you look at the Yankees, who won the MVP for them? It was Giancarlo Stanton. It was one of their big guys. So they're going to rely on their big three with Juan Soto and Aaron Judge and Giancarlo Stanton, whereas the Dodgers, they can get contributions and production down the lineup from other guys that can step up. I mean, Kike Hernandez, Max Muncy, everyone's had a role in this run for LA.
And what's really interesting, I mean, going before the postseason even would start, if you look at the bottom of the order, you would think, they're just, you know, because they're the ones that really have excelled to help them get to where they are now. I mean, if you look from 6 through 9, there are days when you're like, they're just guys, right? Because you look at a Tommy Edman, he's an older guy, he's been around a while now. But, like, he's been very key to their success. I mean, so those guys don't perform, they're probably not sitting in this position right now. I mean, they're really, you could go to Stanton. I mean, it's not like he was like, he's like this huge superstar. I mean, he can have some really bad games.
That's absolutely a fact. I mean, you look at the Yankees, and they've relied on that. I mean, Juan Soto, he gets the big home run in their clinching game. But, I mean, this all started in the NLDS. I mean, you look at Game 5. Who gets the big home run to give the Dodgers their first lead against a Yu Darvish that they struggled with in Game 2? They were struggling with in Game 5. It was Kike Hernandez who steps up and gets the big home run. And then a little later in the game, Teoscar Hernandez, he gets the big home run. So that is the biggest difference between this team. We saw years ago, it was Corey Seager. He stepped up. He carried that team through 2020. Same with Mookie Betts. Now you have a deeper lineup, and that's where the Dodgers have a clear-cut advantage. The Dodgers have a deeper lineup with guys they can trust down the order. I mean, just look at the NLCS. I mean, they scored 46 runs. That was the most ever in a championship series, and it didn't even go to a Game 7. You also set a record for walks, and the plate discipline in the approach has certainly been there. So the Yankees might have a slight advantage when it comes to their starting rotation, but I think the Dodgers, they have the advantage when it comes to a deeper lineup and a better bullpen.
And all of that said, that's why I think it goes 7. I'll give the Dodgers a slight edge because they're at home. I mean, you're DodgersNation.com. You're not taking the Yankees. So how many games do you have this in?
I have the Dodgers in 6 games. I'm going 6, and it'll be the first time the Dodgers win the World Series at home since they swept the Yankees in 1963. The ticket prices, I mean, if you saw the average ticket price right now for Game 1 is at $2,977. Behind home plate is $45,000. I mean, it'd be great if fans could get the same deal the Dodgers got with Ohtani and just defer 97% of the payment until 2034. But, look, the truth is, it's going to be money well spent. If you can get to Dodger Stadium, if you can tune in, we're truly seeing a historic series with two franchises, with the two best players in baseball, the two marquee franchises going at it. I got the Dodgers in 6. I think that when you look at the way this team is built, you got Flaherty in Game 1, Yamamoto in Game 2, you got Walker Buehler in a potential bullpen game in Games 3 or 4, a combination of that. But with the rest and the fact they can reset their rotation, each of their three starters can go twice in this series. So if you like Game 7, I like Walker Buehler in Game 7, but I'll take the bullpen doing it again, the dogs in that Dodger bullpen doing it once again in Game 6. It'd be very fitting, and we would get that parade that we all want, the first parade since 1988.
I know, because then they can get rid of that 2020 World Series, what some would think to get an asterisk next to it, because I was at that
exactly.
COVID World Series where, you know, that season was, what, 60 games? They played 60 games and played around the league. I mean, some sit here and argue with us that didn't even count, right? That literally, some people would sit here and start arguing. They won a World Series, but this would actually be it. You got your parade. Dodger Nation, get that parade. They want the parade. You want the parade. You're going to be like, you're going to be, you're the Grand Marshal. Doug.
I need the parade more than I need oxygen, Matt. Well, I need the parade more than I need tickets to Game 1. I mean, we need that parade. Look, here's the thing. That's what all the players have said. That's what Dave Roberts said. Dave Roberts, after the Dodgers beat the Mets in Game 6, he told the Dodger Stadium crowd hey, you guys want a parade? We need four more wins, four more wins. Kike Hernandez said that they won in 2020 and it was great, but he feels like he was robbed of a parade. Wouldn't you want to see Clayton Kershaw pop in champagne? Wouldn't you want to see Kike Hernandez? I mean, it would be a electric, joyous event to have that Dodgers World Series parade. And you're absolutely right about the haters. There are haters out there that try to minimize that 2020 World Series. I always say that it only became an asterisk World Series when your team got eliminated, right? Yeah. If your team had won it, you'd be celebrating like it was a full season World Series. There's a championship to be won. The Dodgers won it, but I totally agree with you that if the Dodgers win this year, that they silence all the haters. I've called them the incomplete elite when it comes to
that. That's a good one.
And I think that this would totally put them over the top and they would firmly sit at the mountaintop of Major League Baseball and set themselves apart as the best franchise, not only in baseball, but one of the best franchises in professional sports.
Dodgers-Yankees, first pitch flying Friday at 5:08, game two Saturday, 5:08. We got Doug McKain, DodgersNation.com, Dodgers Dugout on YouTube. We got it covered for it. Now just get him a parade. Get him a parade. He'll be like, go!
I need the parade. Grand Marshal, I like that idea. Dodgers, if you're listening, hey, just get me on one of the buses, baby. Give me on one of those double-deckers.
All right, Doug, thank you very much.